ready.
Hello. I want to show you what you can do with a tire and very little money. Got this tire for free. Just an old truck tire. And I cut this piece off. It's very easy to do using a box cutting knife. Shorten it so you don't break the blade. Don't be too ambitious with that first cut. You're not going to be able to cut all the way through. Get your blade in there again. The second time, maybe if you get the camera in close, you can hear the canvas. I'm touching the canvas now. And now this time I should be able to cut all the way through the rubber. Yes, I'm through. So I've cut through, there's my finger. And that's done. Then, after you do cut the top off, flip the tire over and cut, say, three triangles here. That's because if you look in there now, you can see that water would just sit here on the bottom and the roots would get soaked in water. So you need to cut holes. You need to cut some holes in here to let the water out. As you can see, I've already cut through here. I think I might be able to just get my blade in here now and start this cut. So the thing about cutting rubber is if you can spread it out, it cuts very easily. See, I'm pulling it away from itself. When you pull it away from itself, it cuts very well. Now look where on the tire I've done the cut. This is the highest point on the tire. That means if it's upside down, this is the lowest point. And that's where the water will go. So again, try to cut that piece off. So this is just to allow the water to go out the bottom. It doesn't have to look pretty. No one will ever see it. Drainage is so important that you want good drainage. As you can see, I've got two already. I'm going to put a third one here. Then we've just looked around our neighborhood to see if we could find some soil. We found really good compost. There's a place where some birds were roosting in the trees at night, making lots of compost under the tree. But that soil was a bit too rich, so we mixed it with just some gravelly sand, 60% gravelly sand and 40% compost. Then we stuck some basil in here, just some, we thinned out this pot actually. We had perhaps 10, we put about 10 cuttings in here, thinking maybe only one would root, but they all rooted. So we put the extra ones around in a circle. And while those are catching on and growing, we've got some tomato plants in the center. We're only planning to have one tomato plant in here, but as you can see, there's quite a lot of germinated. This is just from a single tomato. We didn't buy tomato seeds or anything. Come follow me, I'll show you the plant we got it from. This here is just one or two plants growing very nicely. We've had to stake it up with bamboo and whatnot. Anyway, this doesn't get much bigger, just a cherry tomato. So, oh, there's one that's red. I didn't see it. We've harvested maybe 30 or 50 of these already. Just pick them like this and they'll ripen up nice and red. And you can just bite into this, squeeze the seeds out, and in a few days you'll have another plant. You gotta always keep planting new tomato plants. They don't last forever.